All right, hey guys, welcome to the Sash. I'm Evan.
I'm Kimmer.
And today, we're gonna review the realistic tape deck.
Yeah, this is a great model. You can get it at Radio Shack, or you used to be able to at least. It's very thin. I think you could, it's pretty lightweight as well. So I love the model, I love the design.
Yeah, it's got some great styling, kind of that retro throwback, kind of like silver metal, very classic looking. Easy to take to a party. It's got a nice handle all the way across the top. You can just carry this with you, put it on your shoulder, take it to a party.
Sure.
Super mobile.
And the price tag gives it like a little bit of color, which I like.
It's got lots of nice plastic knobs. Super long antenna. Look how far out that goes.
I mean, you could be on Mars and maybe pick something up. I don't know. It's pretty good. But again, a lot of functionality and just looks like a great product. So.
But it's got this slick little panel in the back. You pop it open and you just got to throw, let's count them. Just a second. It's really easy to use.
Yeah, it's simple.
One.
Uno.
Two.
Dos.
Three.
Tres.
Four.
Cuatro.
There's like a second level. Five.
Oh, wow.
And six. So it just takes, six single-use C batteries. So as long as you got like a six-pack of these on you, you'll be good to go.
Yeah, you could just get a couple extra packs as well. Run those down with you to the beach. So if these batteries stop working, you can just swap them out real quick.
Yeah, just toss them in your bag. 24 batteries, ought to be good for a trip. Just keep a whole pack of batteries with you.
Better safe than sorry, as they say.
Should we give it a sound test?
Let's do it.
Let's check this baby out. So it's got nice, like I said, nice plastic buttons. They look like metal, but they're plastic on the top.
Love that. I was fooled. I didn't even know.
Pops right open. Look at that. Now, you gotta make sure you put it in the right way.
Yeah.
Because there's two sides and then there's up and down. Some tape players goes down, that doesn't work. Mm-mm. See, it won't close.
Yeah.
So you wanna flip it this way and then you wanna have side one.
Yeah, and if it's
facing out,
right.
If
it's not closing, don't force it. You can break it. So just make sure. Like,
even though it wiggles a little, it's still closed.
Yeah,
and
don't worry about that.
It's not super secure, but it, yeah. Mm-hmm. You want to give it a play?
Sure, which one of these plastic?
The one that says play.
Oh, that's a good way to start, okay.
Oh, we did something wrong, hold on. I might have put the batteries in wrong, hold on. It's a really easy fix. If it's not turning on, you just take three of the batteries back out, flip them around. No, wait, that's not working either.
The volume's up, right? Once you get used to putting them in and taking them out and putting them back in, it's really not that taxing.
Plus, I shouldn't have taken them out. It was working fine before I took them out in the first place. All right, we got power now. That did it. No problem. See, that's an easy fix. Just takes a few minutes out of your day.
No sweat. You hear that bass?
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's got packs of punch. My luck was so bad, I thought I used up all the luck I had. Every time I thought I'd get it on, someone put me on. Thank you.
that was, yeah, I was impressed. And I, especially these options, like you just mentioned, the tone and the balance, you can really kind of manipulate the sound.
Dial it in how you want it.
Exactly.
You
know? Everyone hears a song differently than they would have if they didn't know how else to change this, the knobs.
Now, I couldn't really hear what they were saying, but I think you could still dance to it.
Yeah.
You can still tell it's music.
Yeah.
It's definitely music.
Mm-hmm. It sounds like sometimes he had maybe marbles in his mouth or was underwater, but like also that's not the point, and I still could hear the things I needed to hear.
Yeah, I mean that vintage sound that, you know, it's so valuable now. Kids are getting back into that vintage sound.
Yes, yes. Some things are too clear.
Mm-hmm. It's got some lights on the front, so I think when you're like playing in the... Shows you the levels right there. So you crank it up. That way, it's just another way to keep in check if it's too loud.
Right.
If you can't hear very well, and you need a visual cue that it's too loud.
Yeah.
The dial will tell you.
You can kind of visualize walking into a party with it, you know? It'll get people out there.
Coming up 101, there it is. The 80s double check. The 1980, 1981,
and 1982. That is real loud when you hold it up to your ear like that. So just be careful with that.
Mm-hmm.
You want to compare it to something just to give us a reference?
Yes, that would probably be a good idea.
Okay, so we've got right here JBL Extreme 3 Bluetooth speaker. What does that thing run?
Ooh, it runs...
I mean, the price, it was like
at, $25.95
from a garage sale.
Yep.
Estate sale. This is a cool $299 on Amazon.
So it does cost more money.
Yeah. That's crystal clear.
See, I didn't care for that, really.
Yeah. I mean, you don't always want crystal clear, though.
It was so clear that it felt fake.
To be perfectly clear, it sounded fantastic.
Oh, it sounded excellent. That's but not even my issue.
That's not really what
just
most people want.
Something sounds really good doesn't mean that's what people want in a speaker to listen to.
Let's just remind people. Maybe we could play them both at the same time. Ready, go. I think this was a clear winner.
Yeah, after, especially when you've heard both at the same time.
You want to do a blind test? All right, up next is the other device, of which I'm not going to tell you.
Well, since my baby left me, well, I found a new place to dwell. Well, it's down at the end of Lonely Street, that heartbreak hotel where I'll be. I'll be just a lonely baby. Well, I'm so lonely.
I'm gonna mix it up on you here a little bit.
All right. Okay.
Lovers to cry there in the gloom. Be so, I'll be just a lonely baby. I'll be just a lonely. I'll be so lonely, I'll make it die.
Alright, I want you to point to which one you thought sounded best. Take off that blindfold.
Ooh, realistic.
Yeah, how about that?
Honestly, like, both kind of got me kind of moving a little bit, but this one really, I got butterflies.
There you go. Blind test.
Mm-hmm.
This one's like a third the thickness mm-hmm. of this one. You could almost slide this one into your back pocket.
Mm-hmm. And if you wanted to, you could put like your right next, like on top of your VCR-ish kind of thing. And then it looks like it can just roll right off the table. Yeah.
Rolls right off the table. This solid as a rock.
It's fine.
So if you enjoyed this review, please like and subscribe and comment. Let us know what you thought in the comments, and we'll
tell you if you're right or wrong.
Yeah.
Thanks so much. This has been a lot of fun, and hashtag ears don't lie.